Good morning, agents, and welcome to another daily episode of Target Elute today for Monday, November 30th. In this series, we cover a lot from the Target Elute map to Dark Zone exclusives, highlights for the weekly vendor reset, build and farming suggestions, and much more. I'm Agent Shadow, and if you enjoy this video, consider pressing the subscribe and like buttons below, and remember to comment below as well if you have any questions of the sort. Otherwise, let's go ahead and get this video started. Alright agents, so starting off with the Dark Zone highlights, really there is nothing that's Dark Zone exclusive that's worth farming for today. I will put the weekly vendor resets in the bottom left overlay, and the highlights for those really would be the Baker's Dozen and the Dark Zone West for 152 DZ resources. And then the other thing I would pick up is that 8% bleed resistance mod, which I believe is also in the DZ West as well. Otherwise, the 0F's chest piece at the White House is worth picking up, at least saving in your stash so you don't have to farm for it when you complete the Ridgeway's Pride project, because that's going to require you to donate a 0F's chest piece with Perfect Unbreakable on it, and I don't think the one at the White House vendor is really worth running around on heroic content because it's rolled quite low. That's kind of it for the Dark Zone highlights. We got Elf Summit DZ West. And we got Foundry Bulwark at DZ South and Sokolov at DZ East. None of these have Dark Zone exclusives, so I'm going to skip them and move to the north side now. Alright agents, so starting off with the north side highlights, starting at Camp White Oak, we got Overlord Ornaments. Now what you could farm for today at Camp White Oak would be the Fox's Pair Knee Pads with 8% damage to targets out of cover. That's multiplicative damage, the best type of damage in the game. It's well worth running with or without a rifle or rifle build. Next up, we got Coney Island Ballpark Mask. So there's two exotic masks you can get. The DPS one is Coyote's Mask, and then the status effect one would be the Vile Mask, which it goes great with like an Eclipse Protocol build. And then for a named mask, I would recommend farming Douglas and Harding for this, but it is called the Punch Drunk Mask, and it's baked in with 20% headshot damage, and it goes great with like a Chain Killer chest piece headshot damage build. Next up, we got Grupo Sombro at Coney Island Amusement Park. Now, one piece for DPS builds for that crit hit damage, 15%. And then two pieces, you want all skill haste and skill damage rolls. And that's going to be for that 15% explosives damage. Last up, we got Negotiator's Dilemma at Manning National Zoo. This is a great DPS set for ARs, SMGs, and LMGs. What I'll do is I'll put my double LMG build in the top right corner. It utilizes four pieces of Negotiator's Dilemma. Then, of course, Grupo Sombro Gloves for that 15% crit hit damage. And then the Coyote's Mask for even more crit hit damage and chance. Last up, we got Kinley College. So that's closed today. And then, of course, the Summit. That you pick your own target of loot. So let's go check out what we got on the west side. Alright agents, so starting off with the west side highlights. And, of course, starting off with the gear sets like usual. I'm going to start with Ongoing Directive at the Pentagon. Now, Ongoing Directive is a great like bleed build, DPS type build, so what you want to run this with is LMGs usually, that's what I do. And four pieces with the Eclipse Protocol Backpack and the Ridgeway's Pride is an amazing way to run this, of course. Now, the Eclipse Protocol Backpack, like I mentioned yesterday, in the PTS Phase 2 patch notes, it said that the System Aggravator talent that gives you that 30% amplified damage is going away. So keep that in mind and maybe farm for a good backpack with Wicked on it to replace that as. Otherwise, the next thing I would recommend is Aces and Eights at Tidal Basin Stronghold. Now that's a headshot damage skill, you know, headshot damage like gear set. So what you want to do is mix three pieces with two pieces of Aralda Holding and a Chain Killer chest piece. And then I usually run that with the Mantis exotic because you can get usually around 20 million per headshot when Chain Killer is activated. And then lastly, we got Hardwired at Federal Emergency Bunker. So before TU-12 drops, the best way to run a turret and drone build, in my opinion, would be three pieces of Hardwired, two pieces of Hana-U, and then, of course, the Wyvernware. Now, what you want to do is run Kinetic Momentum or Glass Cannon on the chest piece, and then Combine Arms on the backpack. And what you want to do is farm today at Hana-U in Downtown West to get that perfect Combine Arms talent on the Force Multiplier backpack. That's just the best way to run an Assault Turret and Striker Drone build. Next up, we got rifles at Bank HQ. So there's two exotic rifles you can farm for. That's the Diamondback and the Merciless. The Diamondback's a pretty hard-hitting one, you know, short magazine size. I think it's like 5 rounds. It's great in PvE and PvP. Otherwise, the Merciless is pretty good if you run like three pieces of Striker, or you can run Braced on your chest talent or some weapon handling on your gear sets. You know, that way you can slow down like the insane recoil and maybe increase the rate of fire on it. Otherwise, I definitely recommend picking up the two named rifles. That's the Surge with Perfect Spike, and then the Baker's Dozen with Perfect Lucky Shot. And then lastly, for the best rifle damage talents, I always run Boomerang, Rifleman, and Ranger. Boomerang's probably my favorite, Ranger being my second favorite, and then Rifleman being my third favorite. All right, next up at Constitutional Hall, we got Walker Harris & Co. So this is where you farm for the Chain Killer chest piece, the perfect headhunter on it. There's just no other way to run a headshot damage build, really, so this is always something you want to get. Otherwise, you can farm DCDHQ for chest pieces. There's two exotic ones you can get, the Tardigrade exotic, and then, of course, the Ridgeway's Pride. But you need to complete floor 100 to get the project and then complete the project for it. So if you do have someone like myself who has the Ridgeway's Pride already, then you can ask them kindly if they might be able to share it when they get it to drop. Otherwise, you got Seska at Roosevelt Island for that extra 10% crit hit chance. And then the last couple I'll mention is light machine guns at Lincoln Memorial. You could speed run this mission in under 9 minutes solo. You know, that's great for the Bullet King and Pestilence. Those are two exotics highly worth farming for, especially the Pestilence. And then there's multiple named LMGs that'll be in the bottom left overlay. My favorites would be the Carnage with Perfect Sadist on that ongoing directive build. And then second off would probably be the new Reliable Perfectly Optimized. Last couple we got is Assault Rifles at West Potomac Park. So, of course, the Chameleon with Adaptive Instincts is a great exotic. You know, with my True Patriot build, which is going to be four pieces of True Patriot, the Memento Backpack, and the Sokol of Chest Piece with Intimidate on it, you just want to replace that Sokol of Chest Piece with a Fenris, and then you can run the Chameleon. And that's really, I think, the best way to run it. Otherwise, there's a few named assault rifles that are worth picking up, like the Mechanical Animal of Future Perfection, the Maniac named Military AKM, and the Burnout named FAMAS. Last up, the best type of assault rifles you can get would be the FAMAS, the Military AKM, the Police M4, and the Carbine 7. Those are probably the best archetypes of the assault rifle class. Last up, we got Providence Defense at DARPA Research Lab, so you can farm here today for the Sacrifice of the Perfect Glass Cannon. That amplifies all damage that you deal, all damage, by 30%. But it also amplifies all incoming damage by you by 60%, so it's a very high risk versus reward. So I normally run Obliterate or Intimidate, but this is something some people really like to run. Alright, let's go check out now what we got on the east side. Alright, agents, so starting off on the east side with gear sets like usual, we got Future Initiative over here at Space Administration HQ. Just like Foundry Bulwark, the chest and backpack are raid exclusive to the Iron Horse raid. But if you don't, you know, have a team or whatever to run that, you know, raid over and over to farm for that pieces, what you want to do is run like a chest piece with Empathetic Resolve, usually Alp Summit, and a backpack with Safeguard, and that's just as good of a healer build as having the chest or backpack with Future Initiative. Next up, we got a Close Protocol East Mall. So you guys know this is a great fire damage build. You mix four pieces with the Vile Mask or the Imperial Dynasty holster, and then one piece of Golan gear, and that thing just shreds through content, especially heroic content or in teams. We got True Patriot over here at Federal Triangle. Most people know my True Patriot build already, but if not, I'll put it in the top right card now. Four pieces with the Memento and a Sokolov chest piece with Intimidate, and run the Lady Death with the Mop Shotgun with Close and Personal, and it just shreds through content, and that's for solo and in group. Last gear set we have is in Judiciary Square, that's Striker's Battle Gear, so of course three pieces for that increased rate of fire and weapon handling. Otherwise, I really don't recommend running the four pieces really ever. The damage doesn't stack high enough to really be worth it, you know, compared to an all high-end build, of course. Alright, agents, starting off with the normal targeted loot, we got Badger Tough at Grand Washington Hotel today. You can farm this for the Zero F's chest piece with Perfect Unbreakable, definitely worth farming for, and of course the White House Bender, you can pick it up for the Ridgeway's Pride project. I don't recommend picking it up to actually run with it though. And then Douglas and Harding at Viewpoint Museum, so this is where you get the Punch Drunk Mask with that 20% headshot damage baked into it. Highly worth farming for if you're going to run an all high-end headshot damage build, which is usually what I prefer over the three pieces of aces and eights. Last couple we got is submachine guns at Air and Space Museum. So there's three exotic SMGs you can farm for, the Lady Death, the Chatterbox, and the Backfire SMG. All three of those are worth it, and if you don't have the Chatterbox yet, I'll put the guide in the top right card now. Also, remember that the Dark Winter and the Apartment are Dark Zone exclusive, so you have to wait for SMG targeted loot to be in the Dark Zone to get them. Otherwise, the really good ones that I'd recommend is the Safety Distance with Perfect Outsider. That's a great SMG that does drop in the Light Zone that I would recommend farming for. And there's a few others as well, like the Swap Chain, but I don't really highly recommend farming for those. Last couple things we got here is knee pads at Jefferson Plaza. So there's two exotic knee pads you can farm for, the Ninja Bike Messenger knee pads and the Sawyer's knee pads. Both of those are mainly for DPS builds, but Sawyer's is pretty good for, you know, like a tank build if you're just sitting still behind cover. Otherwise, you can get the Fox's Prayer knee pads here, but I always recommend farming the brand, not the type, so I would farm Overlord instead of knee pads for those. And then the last one we got is gloves at Southwest. So of course the exotic BTSU gloves are definitely worth grabbing up today if you want to farm for them. And then also there's Petrov in New York City today, but you can also farm here in Southwest. If you want to go for the contractor's gloves, that's 8% damage to armor. That goes great on, you know, like with two pieces of Walker Harrison Co. and also damage to armor on your weapon. Or you can just put those on LMG builds. I mean, it's almost mandatory if you're running an LMG. All right, let's go check out what we got in New York City now. All right, agents. So lastly, we're here at New York City Target Aloo Highlights. And really, we only got tip of the spear is the gear set over here. So I don't really recommend it. It increases your specialization weapon damage. Otherwise, I just never, ever use this. I still don't even, because specialization weapons don't really matter that much. But it can be useful in raids and legendaries at specific points. I just really never use it. Like I said earlier, on the east side, we got Petrov at Liberty Island. So you can, of course, farm for the contractor's gloves with that 8% damage to armor. This would be the best way to farm for it. Like I said, farm the brand, not the type, and that's going to yield better results. We got Bellstone Armory at Wall Street. You could farm the Everyday Carrier with perfectly efficient chest piece. Remember, though, that the Liquid Engineer with Perfect Bloodsucker is a Dark Zone exclusive, so you cannot farm for it in the Light Zone. Some pretty good marksman rifles I'd recommend farming for would be the Mantis for sure. The Nemesis is definitely worth it, but you have to complete the quest first. Otherwise, there's a few named ones like the White Death and Ekim's Longstick that are worth farming for. And there's also an Ekim's Longstick with Perfect Ranger at the campus and at the DZ East vendor that are definitely worth picking up, especially at the campus. And holsters at Two Bridges. You got two holsters you can get that are exotic. That's the Dodge City holster and the Imperial Dynasty holster. And then, of course, the Forge holster that gives you 50% extra shield health is also very, very highly worth it for any shield build users out there. Last couple we got is Aralda Holding at the Tombs. I always recommend farming these with weapon damage, weapon handling, and headshot damage. And they go great with the Chain Killer chest piece, you know, a backpack with Vigilance or Composure on it for a good headshot damage build. And then lastly, Backpacks at Stranded Tanker. If you're looking to refarm the Memento, if you've already gotten it from the Season 3 reward track, you can farm Backpack Target Loot and it will drop. Alright agents, well that was the Target Loot for today. Thank you so much for watching and be sure to subscribe, like, and share if you enjoyed my content. If you would like to become a member for support and exclusive perks, that would be amazing, and thank you so much to everyone that does this. I really appreciate what you do. You can also grab some Shadow Gaming merchandise by clicking the link in the pinned comment and video description below. I got lower prices across the board already, but I also have multiple promo codes, 10% off, and then of course free shipping. They'll be in the pinned comment below as well. You can support me on alt tech like Patreon, Subscribestar, Storyfire, and BitChute. But otherwise, for anyone watching this video right now to the end, thank you so much for that. That really probably is the best way to support me. Anyway, agents, take care and stay tuned for more daily Division 2 content. This is Agent Shadow signing off. I will see you in the next video. Take care, agents.